as they come up the start and finish straight, and here they come, Paul. Wait for the noise.
Yesterday. my brother would say, not that other people know that.
There's a reason for that too. But that was left unsaid.
Okay.
Well, it's not going to make a huge amount of difference at this track, but one of the differences between the novelty and the replacement, which is the light British dark blue car, is that the presumption was that the novelty was very, very aerodynamic, but actually it turned out that it was. Just in the air, it's put a bit of the body well enough because so much of it's low. Now, actually, the later Evola body actually doesn't, if it's not as good a speed, it doesn't have the same hot speed.
Clem Proctor, who went on to some notoriety as a professional stock car driver in the 60s,
according to Vickers, claimed that they qualified 17th behind Carroll Shelby for the 1958 FIA Sanctioned USA Grand Prix at Riverside in November 58. The car was a CNF with a low engine on lap 30. Another highlight of the century was Williams' triple R Mark Light ninth race at World Prix of August the 58th. A photo of its history lap was featured on the cover of Motor Racing Volume 3. Can be seen in this photo. I feel the Proctor Special is a significant piece of Southern California racing history. Warner Brothers close to its original specs as possible with as many of its original points as is safe.
Well, yes.
I think actually, yeah, the NAM brings out here a few years back, and that's just some ridiculous thinking along those lines.
Yeah.
Red Fire and Saddler is still knocking off some pretty good times there, and certainly have a decent look.
Yeah, looking at our scoring model, he seems to be lapping about 2 seconds a lap quicker than the rest of the field.
Concept car. This car was built using an front cross member from the donor 365 GT. Frame design and rear suspension are very accurate reproduction of the original TR61. Front suspension is from the donor Ferrari. The rear suspension is a complex multi-link IRS design derived from the transaxle design of Ferrari was developing for the Dino sport cars in the early 60s and utilized on the TR61. The differential of this car is from the 365 GT, a body, an extremely accurate reproduction of the Fantuzzi body from the original TR61 factory racers, and hand-constructed in aluminum and finished almost without any body filler below the paint. Engine is a correct 250 V12, originally from Aluso. It was built by Chryson. Uses the correct 6 drum draft weapon. Transmission is a Ferrari second mesh 5-speed, but the 365 GT and the Ferrari 261, the last of the Testarossas, along with the single 330 GRI of 1962, the last of the front engine Ferrari sports racers. With low sharp nose and higher rear bodywork, the TR61 presaged the look of the mid-engine car in the words to replace it. This car is a careful replication of the original with a correct face frame and hand-formed aluminum body driven by Chryson 250 V12 engine and Ferrari transmission. Equally at all on the street, on the tour, or on the track. When did the car from race cars formerly 1967 to 1984 Formula 1 car to the pre-grid? Cars in race group 4A to the pre-grid now, please.
been installed a sapper out front. Gunner 84, Greg Meyer, second. So Victor Nobly, number 9, Mike Arciero. The Proctor Special, of Ned Bacon, 228, running third. Birthday, Piper, number 7. Andrade Kipo, 61, running fourth. And Frank Zucchi in the Barada is fifth in that Corvair powered Lana Sports Racer Carpenter.
Is
Piranha Sports Racer, the Corvair powered car, car number 3.
Sounds like the Lister might have quit.
And a good place car is the Corona M15 SS. So that's your top 5, the Sandler, the Proctor Special, Roswell, the Birdcage, the Piranha, and the Devon SS. Meyer, Bacon, Fiber, Suzuki, and Corona.